So the crisis game are basically a crisis simulation of political nature. So you're going to get a trigger event for a certain topic. This year it was North Korea. And after that was really up to us as teams to develop our policy papers to look what would our team do. My team was Japan. So our tactic was mostly diplomatical. We tried to do as many treaties as possible, which went horribly wrong after halfway of the game, which was also like an interesting part of it to see how everything can spiral out of control so fast. First of all, it's like a great social experience. You get to meet new people and like you get to talk to different people you would normally not talk to. Then you get a lot of chances to work out policies. You can like think in different way, like for different nations, for different teams. It's strategic thinking. You actually have to deal with a situation that you might have encountered before, but never really thought about how you might resolve it or how you would deal with it in a certain situation. So yeah, it just gives you a really good in-depth look and you learn how to act under a certain pressure. But after all, it's mostly fun. So the location of Gregynog really benefits the crisis game in my opinion because it's far outside Weber. After doing my bachelor's in Aberystwyth, I want to go on to a master's and afterwards work in NGOs in developing countries. I think the crisis games helped me with it and will help me in the future because you just get like a really pressuring situations. You get other parties who do not act the way you want to or you can't really predict the way you want them to be. And it's really great for that. Like in the field I want to go to, it's probably what I have to face quite a lot of times. So it's really good for me to practice it now, I think, as long as it's in like a safe environment where I can't go too wrong.